Hey there, I'm Ray from the ReadMe team, and I'm excited to walk you through our Markdown Editor, Sidebar, and Page Navigation experience. Documenting your API is one of the main reasons why customers choose ReadMe, so it's important that our editor offers a best-in-class experience to make writing that documentation seamless. The faster you can write your documentation and launch your hub, the sooner your end developers can get started with your API. ReadMe largely offers a set-it-and-forget-it approach to your API documentation. However, you do need to keep it maintained and organized to ensure that your docs are up-to-date and reflect what's new and what's different with your API. Our sidebar and page controls aim to make that ongoing maintenance and organization super smooth. So let's jump into this experience and check out some of the features and functionalities. All right, so here we are in a ReadMe project dashboard. This one's a test project of mine called Albert Journey Maps. Albert is ReadMe's mascot. I like to imagine that Albert is a stellar tour guide across cities around the world. Here we are in the guide section, where you can access the full suite of editor, sidebar, and page navigation features. First, we're going to create a new category. The default name for a new category is New Category, but we'll highlight that and replace it with Albert in the Mediterranean. Now that we have our new category, it's time to add our first page. Click this plus icon to add a page to the category. Now we can name that page and add a description. Since this category is about Albert in the Mediterranean, let's pretend that Albert is taking you on a tour of the Acropolis. And let's add a description to that too to give a bit more context. Let's take a look at what each of these page controls do. This dropdown allows you to select what type of page this is. Since we're planning to add additional info to this page versus linking out to another site, we'll leave it checked as a page. This dropdown indicates whether the page is public or private. Since we're still writing this page, we don't want to set it live on our developer hub just yet. We'll keep it as hidden for now, but if we want to share it with others to view, we can still send them a preview URL. All right, now let's review some of the features of our Markdown editor. We designed our editor to combine the best elements of Markdown syntax with the ease of a WYSIWYG editor. On any page in your project where the editor is present, Albert's Getting Started guide is stationed on the right-hand side to help you get acquainted with the editor and show off some of the handy things you can do with it. Let's dive into setting up our page. I'm going to create an H1 header by typing slash to bring up our slash command menu. To add an emoji to the text, as I'm doing here, I can just type a colon to bring up a menu of emoji options. I'll bring up the slash command menu again to add an image. I'll upload this image of the Acropolis from my files. It's a bit larger than I'd like it to be, so I'll reduce the size to 75% of the original. I'll then slide this toggle to add a border and add a caption to this image to give more context. I want to add a new section, so I'll use Markdown syntax to create an H2 header. I have some notes in another app that I want to copy into this guides page. When copying and pasting content, ReadMe's editor preserves all Markdown syntax and renders all blocks and styling when copied from another Markdown editor. I'm going to add a link here. When I highlight this text, a formatting menu appears. I'll click this link icon and paste in this URL to hyperlink this text. Let's save what we've done so far and continue exploring more of the page controls. When I scroll down to this What's Next section, I can add some recommended pages or links to visit after reading this page. First, I'll add a description to give the reader a bit more context. Next, I'll add a couple relevant pages, in this case related to other tours that Albert offers throughout the Mediterranean. Let's head to the top of the page where we'll click this three-dot menu to edit the page's metadata. In this pop-up menu, I can upload a display image, in this case, an image of the Acropolis. I'll also add a title and a description. Lastly, I'm going to shorten the page slug to Albert Acropolis Tour. I'll click OK to save the changes, and you can see at the top that the page slug reflects the new change. This page is good to go for now, so we'll set it to public so that it's now visible on the Albert Journey Maps Developer Hub. We can also reorganize the sidebar to move this category closer to other categories that include Albert-led tours in Europe. For easier dragging and dropping and scrolling, we can click the category name to collapse the category. To drag and drop the category to another location, press, hold, and drag this category to where you'd like it to live and then drop it here. Click the category once more to uncollapse it. You can also move pages between categories by clicking this three-dot menu, scrolling down to the Move To section and choosing a different category. This also applies to subpages. As a last step in guides, let's preview how the page will look in our developer hub. Now it's time to explore the sidebar and page control functionalities in the API reference section. First, we'll add an API definition, which will automatically generate individual API endpoint pages in our API reference. To do so, we'll click this top API definitions page in our sidebar, and then click the Add More Endpoints button. Since the API definition I'm using in this example can be uploaded via URL, I select the API import option and then the URL option. Now I can drop in the URL, click import, and my API endpoint pages will start generating. Now that we've imported the API, the random wow API in this case, we can see these synced endpoint pages in our sidebar. You can use our Markdown editor on any page in your API reference to add text, media, code blocks. Anything that you can do with the editor on a guides page, you can also do here. Let's add a header and then some text to describe what this API does. Pages in your API reference default to API endpoint pages, but you can click this menu in your dropdown to change it to a standard page or external link. I'll keep this page hidden for now and save the page so that I can come back to finishing it at a later date. Let's preview this page to see how it renders in our developer hub. These getting started and authentication pages are templates that are designed to be like a welcome mat for your API. Once you've set up these two pages, your developers can use them to easily locate their API keys and try out your API in real time. You do need to set up the personalized docs webhook for your project or enterprise group first, which you can do in the configuration section of your project or group. And there you have ReadMe's editor, sidebar, and page controls experience. We're really excited for you to try it out. If you have any questions, always feel free to drop us a message via the intercom widget at the bottom right of any page or email our support team at support@readme.io. Thanks!